Hello, Simon here, and welcome back to the channel. It's a pleasure to talk with you again today. And the reason why I'm making this video is because I received an email from a viewer asking me a question. So I'm going to read that email to you. It's about going through the Solitude Circus, or the Cirque de la Solitude in French. So here it goes. I'm going to live translate this email. I'll do my best. Okay, so it's written, hello Simon, my name is Nicolas, I'm 45 years old and I'm reaching out to you after having seen your video about going through the Solitude Circus on the GR20 in July 2020. I would like to go this summer, late June, early July, to do the GR20 from the south to the north, alone, totally autonomously, and I would like to go through the circus, going from Boca Minuta and leaving from Boca to Majdanecka, to finally go back to Asco. As you can see, the way will be the opposite of yours. Also, I would like to ask you some advice, and most importantly, your opinion about if it's feasible to do the hike with a 10 kilo bag without equipment specific for climbing, because I read, truthfully or not, that without those equipment, it can be very, very risky. Hence why I'm asking for your feedback. Thank you very much for your time. Looking forward to read. Friendly, Nicolas. Okay. So, well, Nicolas, first of all, thanks a lot for reaching out. My pleasure to share a bit my experience with you. And I'm going to answer your questions. So first of all, my advice, and then my opinion on the feasibility of the hike with a 10 kilo bag. So about the advice, I have a couple of ones. The first one, it's about the weather condition. You want to make sure that the weather conditions are okay to do the hike. And how you can know that? Well, you go to the shelter and you ask the guardian and you ask him, how does the weather forecast look like? Because if the weather conditions are not good, then you should absolutely not attempt the hike, because it's very dangerous and there were some pretty bad injuries in the past year. So definitely do not go if the weather conditions are not okay. That's the first one. Then the second one, it's about avoiding getting lost. And to avoid to get lost, first of all, once again, you have to ask the guardian and you tell him, hey, I would like to do the circus. Can you please let me know how I can get there? Because when you leave the shelter, you will see the markers of the GR20 to go to the new pass, which is going through the Monte Cinto. So it can be a bit tricky to find the old pass. So ask the guardian about what is the pass. Then, once you are in the Solitude Circus, you must find your way with the markers which are erased. And to do that, I will show you a trick. Actually, I discovered about a GPS application which allows you to see some traces of trails. So, allez, let's see how it works. So, you need a GPX file. So, let's look for it. Cirque de la Solitude GPX, right? Okay, let's go on the first one, Visu GPS. Let's download it. Okay. Download. Right. Downloads. Okay, and now you want to open it in Gaia GPS. Gaia GPS, it's a freeware, so meaning that it's an application you can get for free on the App Store. Okay, let's open it. All imports completed. And now you see, this is a map. So, okay, currently I'm in Brussels, but then let's move to Corsica. And you see, now on the map, you have this blue trace, which is the hike of the Solitude Circus. So, you can see it starts from Asco, and then here it goes to Boca to Majdanecka, and then leaves at Boca Minuta, and then you make it to Tiget. So you'll be doing it in the opposite direction, but with this, it will be pretty helpful once you're in the circus to make sure that you are not completely off track. And so that's the first one. Make sure you are kind of on the trace. And also, when you are doing the hike, make sure you can always see a marker, like every 5 minutes. After 10 minutes, you didn't see any marker, then you might want to go back to the last one you found and make sure that you find cairns and markers. Yes, those markers, they are covered, but you can still spot them. So that's for my advice. I guess that's the last one, which is about when you're at the shelter before leaving, just talk to the folks and say, hey, look, guys, I would like to make the Solitude Circus hike tomorrow. Is anyone up for it? Because maybe there's a crew of people with you and then you're not fully alone. And it's safer because on the GR20, there's always a lot of people. So if you get injured, you mean someone will spot you. But the Solitude Circus, not always. So make sure you can ask if there is a crew of fellow hikers who want to go with you. Then about the feasibility. Well, that's entirely up to you, honestly. Depends a bit on your confidence and your skills. But what can I tell you? I can tell you that the paths of the Solitude Circus, they are not extremely extremely harder than the other paths in the GR20. The difference is that there are no equipments, so there are no chains, there are no ladders. So how can you foresee that? Well, when you are in the hikes, so you'll be coming from the south, so when you'll go through the La Brèche du Capitello, just before Ninos Lake, there are some pretty tricky paths. Try to do those paths without the help of the equipment. Like, just try to go up without the chains, and if you make it and if you feel comfortable, then yeah, it should be fine in Solitude Circus. But on the other hand, if you struggle a bit without the equipment because your bag is too heavy or whatever, then you might want to reconsider and yeah, go through the Monte Cinto. That's it. I hope it helps. And if you have any other questions, feel free to ask in the comment section below. And yeah, I'll keep you posted and see you next time.
Okay, I think I see an indication there and there. So that's the right track.